In this tutorial, we'll show you how to safely remove duplicate designs using the built-in wizard. For a written copy of this lesson, use the Help Contents command and navigate to the Tutorial Topic 16 under the header Manage Your Design Collection. Since we've already extracted the sample designs from their zip archives, we're ready to go. We're in Explore mode, and the main folder is selected. This folder, and optionally all its subfolders, will be examined for duplicates. The Remove Duplicate Designs tool searches the top of the current folder through all of its subfolders for embroidery design files which have the same name but different formats. The wizard does not compare files in different folders, as those duplicates may be intentional. Also, the contents of zip archive files are not processed, so be sure to extract them first if you wish to include them. Even though you'll be safely moving your duplicate designs to a backup folder or to the system recycling bin, it is always recommended to backup your designs prior to using this tool. See the comments below for a link to our video on how to backup your embroidery designs using Buzz Explore. On the first dialog, read through the information, check the I understand box, and click Next to continue. The first time you run the wizard, you'll need to set up your preferences. Using the drop-down, select the file type priority for your embroidery machine. To customize the list to your preferences, click the Copy to Custom, and then use the arrow buttons to move the formats up and down on the list. The Always Keep list stores formats that will not be removed. Use the Edit button to make changes to these formats. Finally, tell the wizard what to do when it finds a duplicate. You can delete them from your collection, which moves the duplicate designs to the Windows recycling bin, or you can have the duplicates moved to a specific folder. Use the Advanced Settings button to change the location of the log file or the handling of the extraneous color files used by some embroidery formats. Click Next, and the first duplicate is displayed on the Verification dialog, where you can move individual files between the Keep and Remove lists. On the bottom left of your screen is a status box, which displays information about the folders it's processed. This needs to stay open or the wizard will close. You can continue to verify each duplicate or click Finish to have the rest of the design files processed automatically. When the wizard finishes processing the main folder, it will ask you if you want to process subfolders as well. We're clicking Yes to continue. When the Remove Duplicate Designs tool is finished, you'll receive a final message that links to the Duplicate Designs folder, if you used one, and the Logs folder. Use the Open Logs folder button to open the Log File folder. The log files are created every time you run the Remove Duplicate Designs tool, and it records what action was taken to your designs and why. Once you no longer need the log files, feel free to delete them. That's it. You can now use Buzz Explore to view the contents of your cleaned up folders. Doesn't that look better?